you can't really view it as union busing because they're an association, and under the laws that they have, his actions seem to be okay. But for us, it is the usual tactic, and it cannot be condoned. If these rights that the association has is not sufficient, then we need to expand those rights so that these people can defend their rights. In essence, I would go as far as to say it's association busting.
Does the NTUCB see this as a heavy-handedness of police high command out of touch with the rank and file?
Indeed, it is a clear indication. And sometimes I'm wondering if that is the way that we try to deal with the crime situation, try to use a heavy-handed approach instead of trying to address the key critical issues that are creating this crime wave that we have in our country. And for us, there are other ways of addressing these things, and hence the reason why we've put our collective might in this process.
Now, in your release, you have called on the Commissioner and the Minister of Police to rectify this situation with much haste. What are you suggesting be done?
Based on the grievances that the officers, especially the one with the transfer, according to Mr. Kelvin, I heard him yesterday on CRIM trying to explain away what has happened with the minister and these officers. Certainly, there was a commitment to deal with the issue of transfers, to let it fall in line with their act. And so that is an initial process. But as I said, we want to meet with the ministry and the minister and to see if we can be a mediator-type person within this process to see if we can get to some conclusion. So I can't really preempt what those conclusions will be. We have to discuss, and that is the reason why these people need to have the ability to become unions.